of COVID patients has drastically reduced at the Nambole Special COVID-19 Isolation Center, something officials attribute to the current lockdown. The facility used to admit up to 20 patients on a daily basis and now takes in only 5, which is a big relief to many of the frontliners who are working there.
Parliament's COVID-19 task force today paid a courtesy visit to the COVID-19 isolation centre in Nambole. The facility, which has 1,200 beds, is currently admitting only 40 moderate and severe patients. Dr. Ivan Chisure, the in charge of Nambole Treatment Centre, says the lockdown has helped reduce the number of patients admitted.
I believe that the lockdown has helped reduce on the rate of transmission, and we are actually already seeing a decline in the number of patients. So I think that the lockdown has served its purpose, and I hope that even if the lockdown is lifted, the numbers will not go up again.
20 patients have died at the facility since it was reopened in May 28th. According to Dr. Chisure, health workers are facing housing challenges.
Currently the housing units are 20, but I mentioned that we are already 48. And we anticipate that when the patients increase, still we shall need more houses. So we request that if the housing units can be added, such that health workers, so some of the health workers are currently commuting from home, and given the current lockdown, transport is a challenge. So we would have wanted that all health workers reside within the facility.
Frontliners at Nambole are yet to receive their risk allowances since they resumed treatment in May. To make matters worse, health workers are concerned that their allowances are being subjected to 30% taxation.
February, March, April, we are not on ground because COVID had kind of declined.
How much is it?
So the rate is 80,000 per day for 20 days because it's assumed that a health worker works for 20 days in a month, since we have to have some offs.
But you work on the weekend.
You may be off on Monday and you work on Saturday.
Mm.
Yeah. Mm. So it is calculated at that rate of 80 for 20 days, which is 160, though it is also taxed.
Members of Parliament questioned how hardship allowances, which delivered on mobile money, can be subjected to pay as you earn.
These people are sacrificing their lives. You know what's meant by treating a COVID patient? Now, why do you tax a hardship allowance, yet it takes long to come?
We are so certain, and we don't know where after leaving the 30% tax levy from the allowances of the nurses, where is it, where does it go? Who gives accountability for it?
However, MPs were impressed with facilities and services at Nambole and asked the Ministry of Health to establish HDU and ICU facilities to beef up treatment.
This facility of Nambole is a bit organized compared to other facilities in the country because they have a good number of beds, they have enough staff.
If at all it has that kind of infrastructure, then this facility will help our people better. Instead of then transferring them to Mulago Hospital where it is congested already. If at all they have that, then we don't need to transfer patients, especially if at all we plan to be able to contain the third wave.
Unlike other COVID-19 treatment centers with oxygen shortage, Nambole is fully equipped with 200 oxygen cylinders. Story compiled by Fred Kajibi for the news, Nambole.